Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the previous lectures, we introduced quadratic functions. In this lecture, we will examine two standard ways to write a quadratic function, the general form and the vertex form, and see how those forms are related to the function's graph. We have seen that any quadratic function of x can be written as ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b, and c are constants that determine the shape and position of the function's graph. We will refer to this form of a quadratic function as the general form. So let's see how in general form the constants a, b, and c affect the function's graph. As we have seen, the graph of any single variable quadratic function always has the same basic shape called a parabola. In general form, the constants b and c do not affect the parabola's shape, only its position. When b and c are zero, the parabola's vertex will lie at the origin. Only the constant a affects the parabola's shape, determining whether the parabola opens up or down and how tightly it curves. Increasing the value of a stretches the parabola vertically, producing a narrower parabola. And decreasing the value of a shrinks the parabola vertically, producing a wider parabola. As the value of a approaches zero, the parabola approaches a horizontal line. But since the value of a in a quadratic function cannot be zero, the parabola must always have some curvature. Negative values of a will cause the parabola to open down. And just as with positive values of a, negative values of larger magnitude will produce narrower parabolas. The constants b and c don't affect the shape of the parabola, but together a, b, and c all affect the position of its vertex. When b and c are both zero, the parabola's vertex will lie at the origin. Since c adds a constant value to the function at every point, changing c causes the parabola to shift vertically, either up when c is positive, or down when c is negative. Changing the value of b also causes the parabola's position to shift, but in a more complicated way. Positive values of b cause the parabola to shift down and to the left, and negative values cause the parabola to shift down and to the right. So by adjusting the values of both b and c, the parabola, whose shape is defined by a, can be positioned at any point on the Cartesian plane. However, it is not always intuitively obvious which values to choose for b and c in order to position the parabola at a given point. To make the position of a parabola more obvious from its mathematical form, quadratic functions are often written in what is called standard or vertex form. In both the general and vertex forms, the constant a determines how tightly the parabola curves and whether it opens up or down. However, the constants B and C in the general form and H and K in the vertex form affect the parabola's position in different ways. Unlike B and C in the general form, in the vertex form, H and K are the actual horizontal and vertical coordinates of the vertex. This allows us to identify the coordinates of a parabola's vertex simply by looking at the function. For example, the horizontal and vertical coordinates of this parabola's vertex are 4 and 2. This makes it much easier to sketch the graph of a quadratic function written in vertex form, since once the direction that a parabola opens and the position of its vertex are known, parabolas have the same basic shape. The only difference, which is determined by the magnitude of A, is that the parabola may be wider or narrower. For example, let's say that we wish to sketch the graph of the quadratic function 1/3 x minus 3 squared minus 1. In this function, the values of h and k are 3 and negative 1, which tells us the coordinates of the parabola's vertex. And since the sine of A is positive, we know that the parabola opens up. Since all parabolas have the same basic shape, varying only in their width, given just one additional point on the parabola, we can determine how much the parabola must be stretched horizontally. To do this, we can pick any convenient value of x and then solve for the value of f of x at that point. For instance, in this example, we could pick an x value of 0 and then solve for f of x to see where the parabola intersects the vertical axis. Since when x is 0, f of x is 2, we know that the parabola must be stretched horizontally until it intersects the vertical axis at 2. It is obvious that when sketching the graph of a quadratic function written in vertex form, the fact that the constants h and k are the coordinates of the parabola's vertex is helpful. However, it is not so obvious why h and k are the vertex's horizontal and vertical coordinates. In the next lecture, we will see why this is the case.